Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to Second Son Woodworks. My name is Caleb, and today I'm going to be showing you how I built this epoxy top dining room table made with an old farmhouse door and plumber's pipe. This is a great project for those of you who need a really durable kitchen table. So stick around and I'll show you how I built this. The first step in this project is to clean up all of the plumber's pipe. I will be using 3/4 inch galvanized steel plumber's pipe for this project, and the best way that I have found to clean these pipes up is by using a razor blade to scrape all of the stickers and tape off, and then I use some mineral spirits to clean off the black set that accumulates on the outside, and then I use some high grit sandpaper to get it ready for the spray painting. Like I said before, I'm using the 3/4 inch steel pipe for this project, but you can use any size you'd like, such as the 1/2 inch or the 1.5 inches. But I have found that the 3/4 inch looks really proportional with regard to using this as a base for a tabletop. Once I had finished cleaning all the pipe up, I went ahead and started putting the bases together. And what I use to connect everything together is T's, and then I use the caps to cap off the bottom of the legs, and then 4 flanges to cap off the top of the legs, which will be getting attached to the base of the tabletop and the bench. I should also mention that I don't use any sort of pipe thread sealant when I am putting these pipes together. Instead, I guess wear rubber gloves and tighten everything up as tight as it can go. And then once I actually attach the bases to the tabletop and the benchtop, there won't be any sort of movement. I use black caps for the base of the legs, and I don't tighten these all the way so that if the table ends up on an unlevel surface, you can adjust these to level out the table so that it doesn't wobble. Once I had finished assembling the bases, I went ahead and got a measurement for the length of the bench, and then I took a 2x10 that I picked up at Home Depot and cut it down to the rough length. And then after cutting down this 2x4, I took it over to my joiner to get a straight face that I could later on reference on my table saw to get the overall desired width. Once the 2x10 had been completely squared up, I went ahead and took it back over to the miter saw and cut it down to the final length. And then I took it back over to my workbench and took a 1/4 round bit with my DeWalt router and rounded off the edges. The next step in the project was to get the door ready for the epoxy fill. And the first step in this was to remove all the old hardware on the door. This took a bit of time as some of the hardware had been rusted into the door. But once I finished removing all the old hardware, I went ahead and moved on to the sanding process. And this took the majority of the time. As I started with a 60 grit paper so that I could remove all of this old finish. But it was worth it in the end because a lot of the character in the wood began to shine. Once I had completely finished sanding down the door, I went ahead and moved on to staining it. And for this project, I'll be using Varathane's dark walnut classic wood stain, which I really think brought out a lot of character in the wood and was a good choice. Thank you. All right, guys, this is the first time I've done an epoxy fill on this scale. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill in these recesses in the door with epoxy. Like I said, this is the first time that I've ever done a fill this big. I've worked with epoxy before, but on a much smaller scale. So to get started, recommend reading the instructions for the epoxy. For the epoxy that I'm using the Pro Marine Supplies just a clear epoxy. It's one part resin, and then the second part is the hardener. It actually comes with a website to pull up the instructions. So make sure that you follow the instructions to a key. And as you can see, I am down in my basement right now because my shop is just too cold with the winter. I can't get it up to the proper degrees, so I'm gonna do it inside. And I got a space heater right over here to try to boost up the heat. You're supposed to do it around 75 degrees or higher. So that's what I'm gonna be doing, or that's why I'm doing it here inside. So for the first part, I'm going to be doing what they call the seal coat. So it's just gonna be a really small, thin coat that will seal up the wood. And then after that, I'll do a fill coat and actually fill in these recesses. So let's get started.
Like I said before, make sure you thoroughly read through the instructions for the epoxy that you end up using. For this Pro Marine tabletop epoxy, I will put a link for this in the description below, but they provided a website that had a video and a whole bunch of tips and tricks for how to pour this epoxy. I would also recommend getting bigger buckets for the mixing process. You've probably seen this trick all over the internet, but if you use your blowtorch, you can blow out all of the bubbles that accumulate when you pour the epoxy. Thank you. I was to do this pour again, a couple of the things that I would do differently is I would use a bigger bucket than the one that I'm using right here. Use more of like a big painter's bucket, like one of the Home Depot orange buckets, so that when I do the mixing process, I could just do one big pour as opposed to, you know, switching back and forth between pouring and mixing. And then additionally, I would also order more epoxy and just have more than enough. I ordered this stuff off of Amazon. I'll put a link in the description below. But I ended up running short on epoxy down here at this end. So I had to order more and then do the second part of the pour, which led to me having to do some sanding, which you'll see here later on in the video. But just order more than enough if you're going to be ordering it off of the internet. Once I finished the pour, I went out to my shop and got everything ready to do the painting of the bases. Like I mentioned earlier on in the video, I use mineral spirits to clean up the pipe, but then also off video, I use some sandpaper to scuff up the metal. I will probably get a few comments from people saying that you can't use spray paint on metal. It's not going to actually adhere and it will peel off easy. You're not wrong about that, but for a project like this, this is going to be used inside. It's not going to be exposed to the elements. And the wear and tear that happens over time will look natural and add to the character of the piece. Once the epoxy had fully cured, I took the tabletop out to my shop and I used a packing blanket on my bench so that I could lay the tabletop face down onto my bench and it wouldn't get scuffed up. And then I used a chisel to chip away at all of the drip marks of the epoxy that had ran over the edges. Then I used my sander and sanded it up, cleaned up the underside. I didn't worry about it being too pretty. I just wanted it to be nice to the touch of your hands while you're sitting at the table. Once I had finished cleaning up the underside, I flipped the top over, and then I had to sand and kind of equalize out some of the spots on the table where I had to do the second part of the pour. As I mentioned before, when I ordered the epoxy, I didn't get enough epoxy the first time, so I had to order more. The way that I got these imperfections out of the top of the table is I started at a really low grit paper, 120 grit paper, to sand out the imperfections and equalize the epoxy. And then I slowly moved up sandpapers, you know, from 120 to 220 to 320. And then I actually went all the way up to 2000. I used Festool's 2000 grit sandpaper. And I'd actually recommend if you have to do something like this, to go to an even higher grit paper. As I got closer and closer to using the 2000 grit paper, I began to use a little bit of water with the sandpaper. I have found that wet sanding can be super effective to get a really clean finish. I finish off the process with a super fine steel wool, some mineral spirits, and a little bit of linseed oil. After that, I went ahead and flipped the top over to attach the base. I slowed down the video in this shot so that you can see the top. I think it turned out great. Once the bases for both the table and the bench have been attached, the project is complete. I want to give a huge shout out to Music by Winx for contributing all of the awesome beats that you hear in the background. If you like what you hear, check out their Facebook and Instagram page, link below. Kyle, you're the man. I appreciate you so much. There you have it, guys. You have watched another episode of Second Son Woodworks here on my YouTube channel. My name is Caleb. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Please leave questions or comments below. Subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell icon so that you get notified when I post new videos. And build something cool.